Today's topic is Aristotle and the modern world. Aristotle was a very great philosopher of his age, and he has profounded in the theories mainly in context of politics. And now today we will discuss only the one topic, that is a good citizen and good life. The whole philosophy revolves around the concept of good life and good citizenship. He believes that the whole aspect of human behavior revolves around the purpose or end of life, which he calls teleological reasoning. And what is the purpose of life? What is the end of life? Which means that what was the purpose of life, and how we realize this purpose in the society as an individual. So this was the main criteria or parameter of the life in itself. So good life, he particularly profounded that the politics is the only subject wherein the nature of human can be realized. And those rules, roles which the person has to be to adopt, is the virtues, and these virtues has to be modeled into some roles, and these roles may be given to the those people who has that characteristics or virtues or nobleness, to which are fitting to that roles. The other criteria was the fitness of a person to these roles, and the third one was the practicability. These roles are virtues, they only be practiced, and by the means of habits they can be practiced, and then the person becomes a good citizen and society becomes a good society. The criticism of this whole theory of Aristotle was the justification for the slavery. Unfortunately, he supported the concept of slavery. He thought that there are some people who are cut out or fit to be slaves. Those people who are very intellectuals, they go for the legislation into the assemblies, and the manual works and the homework trivial or manual work is being done by these slaves. But these slaves, unfortunately, they were the beaten people in the wars, so they cannot be a fit people to be in slaves. So this aspect of slavery, a justification for the slavery, is a black spot on this fairness of an Aristotle. Even we the Aristotle's concept of justice, distributive justice, is away from the freedom of a person, and even from the moral deserts, that morally which persons deserves he should be given. Then the other philosophers, the follow-up philosophers, disagreed with the distributive justice of Aristotle on these two concepts. Number one is justification of slavery and the denial of the fundamental freedoms. So these two were the differentials between the Aristotle and the follow-up philosophers. However, the Aristotle thought of a utopian society based on equality of opportunities, but some way his concept deny the equal opportunities, equal opportunity concept, because when the person is born and he is fit to hold an office, and manual work is being done by the slaves, so this whole concept in some way denies the concept of freedom, individual freedoms and equal opportunities. So it was developed by the follow-up philosophers that fundamental freedoms are also necessary, good society is also necessary, and slavery is not the inherent characteristics of the some people who are cut out or who are born to be slaves. So the Aristotle's concept of justice has some positive points and mainly negative points, mainly the justification of slavery. Thank you very much.